She is a strange terrain, a soft and slowly moving relief map, yet unmappable, impossible to navigate the same way twice. Body of water, mountains, meadows, valleys, ravines. And a disquieting but inviting mangrove swamp. Damp lagoon. Sinuous roots like the secret skeletons of silkworms. Bubbles it takes a hovering dragonfly to spy. Faint, fluid, fragrant, visceral odor, almost a scent. Tidal, mammal, gasping orchid.
The mangrove marsh leads to a cave system, perhaps impossibly complex. Perhaps not.
Back on the surface, plateaus, mounds, undulations. Then another kind of surface entirely. Shimmering darknesses. Phosphorescence. Depths of interiors that can't possibly be penetrated. Not truly. Expert expedition parties could go missing. Adventurers and naturalists, soldiers of fortune, psychics who believe. Maybe there are unencountered peoples clinging to a last dense jungle refuge. Maybe there's a crystalline aquatic salamander that hasn't yet been discovered. Or on some island, a waterfall that seems to defy time.
Thank you.
literally embedded in a topography of debauched linen.
Debauched? Innocent? What meaning does this polarity present when faced with the business end of a relaxed, naked woman? Of course, there's more to any world than flesh and wall and need. But being in skin suggests longing to be within other skins.
There's also just pure ectoplasm.
Delight.
Yes. There's good reason to be afraid. Quicksand of reasons. What could be more dangerous than a partially cultivated wilderness without boundaries? No survey, no satellite. Who wouldn't be worried about a mysterious sea?
Abandoned temples.
Unknown fossils.
Hieroglyphs.
But what does anyone's fear or longing matter when intimately confronted with the calm, curved, uncompromising ambivalence